Good morning, Rangeland First Grade. Today is Monday, April 13th, 2020. I hope you all are doing great. Miss Burnette, Miss Bates, and I miss you all and miss being in the classroom with you all. If you need anything, make sure you let us know. Also, make sure you remind your parents that they need to send us pictures of what you've been working on or upload it to Google and email it to us. Today, I want to talk about writing and what we want to write about. Sometimes when we start a writing piece, we think, oh, I don't know what to write about. I know that in the classroom, a lot of you were struggling with this as we were working on writing a lot every day before we left. So if you don't know where to start, just write from the heart. So I hope you have notebook paper or a journal that you can keep, because what we're going to be doing in writing is a journal. Let me show you what you can be using. That would be perfect. One of these little spiral notebooks would be perfect because it would keep everything together. And then you'd have a record of what you've been working on in writing. So don't know where to start, just write from the heart. So the first thing you're going to do is create a big heart on your paper. And then inside, you're going to write things or draw pictures of things that are important to you or people and places that you like to go. Let me give you an example of what I wrote in mine. I put pets. I know many of you have different kinds of pets. I believe it's Jesseline has a bird, I think, and she just got a puppy. A lot of you have dogs and cats. Well, I have a dog, Molly. So I drew a picture of a dog. I put a picture of a cat too, because there's a neighborhood cat who liked to come and visit. And so I have pets. Over here, I have my family. I have me and Mr. Carter, Robert, and Catherine. So you can draw a picture of your family or anybody who lives in your house. I drew a picture of a TV because I really love to watch TV. So maybe I'll tell you about some of my favorite TV shows and what's happening on them. Your teachers. Maybe you want to talk about your teachers at school. Maybe about watching this video and what Mrs. Carter had to say. Maybe you want to talk about your special area teachers, Miss Wydell, Mr. Faulkner, Miss Evans, Mr. Abel. Okay, so teachers. Yesterday I was thinking about it and I didn't add video games. My family loves to play video games. Not me, but Robert and Catherine and Mr. Carter. Maybe you want to talk about birthdays or special events. I know this year our birthdays look a lot different because we can't necessarily celebrate with our friends and family. My birthday is coming up soon and I won't be able to celebrate with people outside of my house, but we can still make it special. So maybe we can talk about that. Special events. Right now is an important time of year because there's a lot of holidays coming up. So I added holidays over here. I drew some pictures. There's a pumpkin and a Christmas tree and some fireworks and a football, because maybe in your family, you guys are big Super Bowl fans and you make that a huge celebration. I also included food and restaurants. Now my class knows that I love McDonald's, that every morning I go to McDonald's and get my sweet tea. See, I already went this morning. So maybe your favorite food and favorite restaurants. Places you like to go. Like my family loves to go camping, so maybe I would talk about camping. I know Zenobia, she really likes the beach because she'll tell stories about going to the beach. So there you go. I know lots of you have special toys. The girls, oh my goodness, LOLs and Barbies. Yeah, tell us stories about them. Maybe you can make up a story, because like I know when I used to play with Catherine with our Barbies, we used to make up stories with them playing together. Make up stories about that. It doesn't have to be, that's called a personal narrative or a narrative. So it doesn't have to be exactly about what you did today. Write about your friends. Maybe you have a special friend you miss. I know Bryson's moved away, and right before school got out, we had gotten an email from him. So maybe you have a special friend. Maybe you are missing your friends right now, and so you want to talk about that, or about things you were doing, or what you want to do when you see them again. The last thing I put up here is injuries and illnesses, because I've had lots of surgeries. And I'm very, very klutzy. So I end up with lots of Band-Aids. In fact, we just ran out and I had to go buy some more because I cut my finger. So I just drew a Band-Aid for injuries and illness. So when you're not sure what to write about, you can go to this heart in the front of your journal and look at it and find something that you could write about. Now, one of the great things about keeping a daily journal is you can just write about what you did today. So, for example, I'm going to, first of all, put my date at the top. So I know today is 4/13/2020. I'm going to start over here on my left-hand side of the paper, and I'm going to write, today I learned how to record and upload a video to YouTube. I took Molly for a walk and drove to McDonald's. Period. We know that good readers always reread their work to make sure it sounds and flows well. Today, I learned how to record and upload a video to YouTube. I took Molly for a walk and drove to McDonald's. Remember, it doesn't really matter how many sentences you write, but that you just express something every day and practice writing. Because it's a skill that gets better with practice, just like reading and math. It's very important. I hope you all have a great day. I can't wait to read your writing. We miss you. Bye.